Hey guys, hope everybody's having a good week. Today I want to talk specifically to health and fitness coaches about the importance of disclaimers, whether they be in your coaching agreement, your webpage policy, attached to your social media, attached to your marketing materials. Regardless of where the disclaimers are, they are critically important. And here is why. So disclaimers basically have two main purposes. One, to limit your liability. And two, to say no warranties, no guarantees. So here's what I mean by that. So limitation of liability. A disclaimer is, I like to call a disclaimer a liability shield, which is kind of a misnomer because really, unfortunately, when it comes to law, there's no such thing as something that's gonna shield you completely. You can always be sued, but what a disclaimer does is it limits the chances that anybody's gonna be successful if they do sue you. So what the limitation of liability does is it says, for example, if it's on your webpage, it's going to say that anybody who comes to your webpage and uses or misuses the information on your webpage does so at their own risk. Let's say you write a blog post and you recommend a particular supplement or a protein powder, and somebody buys it and uses it and somehow gets sick, and they want to come back and try and sue you saying that they wouldn't have tried this product if not for your recommendation. That limitation of liability is going to say, well, tough luck. You assume the risk, and they want to come back and try and sue you saying that they wouldn't have tried this product if not for your recommendation. That limitation of liability is going to say, well, tough luck. You assumed the risk when you came to our webpage and used our information. And fitness coaches, believe it or not, but for those of you who post exercise videos regularly, whether on your webpage or on your social media, there are cases where coaches have been sued on the basis of someone watching their exercise video and injuring themselves and then trying to hold the coach accountable. So here's where a limitation of liability within a disclaimer policy also works to your benefit because, again, assumption of the risk. One thing I want to point out really quickly before switching to guarantees, since I did mention product recommendations, is the disclosure of affiliate relationships. So going back to the nutritional supplement example, where you had a blog post and you recommended a particular supplement. Let's say that you're an Amazon affiliate, and if someone were to buy that nutritional supplement through your link, then you get a commission. You need to disclose that. You're probably already aware of that, but disclosing it just in the post is not enough. You need to make sure that you also have it disclosed in a disclaimer policy. Most people would disclose that in their webpage disclaimer policy. And I'll talk more about this at a future date, but just want to bring it up now since it is pertinent. The other important piece of disclaimer policies is guarantees, warranties. So think about this in the context of testimonials. Let's say you have testimonials on your website or your sales page saying, you know, maybe previous client X lost 10 pounds through your fitness regimen, or client Y experienced, renewed health and remission of some sort of chronic illness symptoms. Whatever it is, you have testimonials on your website or your sales page, your social media, your marketing materials, etc. You need a disclaimer saying that just because that client achieved those results doesn't mean that anybody seeing that testimonial and purchasing your services is also going to achieve the same results. Hopefully that didn't seem like too much information thrown at you, because at the end of the day, it's actually really simple to get this level of protection for your coaching business. So here's what I would recommend if you are a health and fitness coach and want to comprehensively protect yourself. One, if you're coaching one-on-one, a great quality one-on-one coaching agreement is going to have a strong disclaimer policy. If you're coaching one-to-many, a terms of use for group programs is going to have the same thing. You also need a strong disclaimer policy for your webpage, and I have through Celiv again, I also have a mini disclaimer for specifically for health and fitness coaches that attaches to your social media and any marketing materials, especially if you promote testimonials or make any sort of recommendations as